Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Neetu's World. Today I'm going to explain and discuss a brief summary of the one-act play Riders to the Sea. It is a one-act play written by J.M. Synge, John Millington Synge. Before jumping into the main section, we should know the few things about the play Riders to the Sea. The play, which was performed in 1904 in Dublin, so it is an one-act tragedy. The play is set in the Aran Island of the west coast of Ireland. So now, let's look at the main characters. The characters, Maura. She is an old widow. She is the protagonist of the play. And she has two daughters, Kathleen. Kathleen is her elder daughter, and Nora, she is her younger daughter. And she has husband and father-in-law. She has six sons, Stephen, Sean, Seamus, Patch, Michael, and Bartley. Bartley is her last son. Bartley is Maura's last remaining son, who has also died by drowning. So altogether there are 11 members in her family. So now I'm going to begin the summary of this short play Riders to the Sea. Riders to the Sea is a one-act tragic play which has been written by an Irish playwright, J.M. Synge. This short play is about the calamities inflicted by the sea on a family of fishermen on an island to the west of Ireland. The story of this one-act play centers around an old woman named Maura and her family. It also shows the reality of the sea riders who are living by the sea. For sea riders, the sea is the main source of income to survive their life as well as their death. Maura is the protagonist of this one-act play. She is a typical mother who lives entirely for the welfare of her children. She prays for them all the time. She had a lot of trouble in giving birth to her sons, but the sea started swallowing them up, and at the end she was left only with her two daughters, Nora and Kathleen. Maura had eight male members, including father-in-law, husband, and six bold sons, but at the end of the play no male member left in her family. All of them became a victim of evil fate or circumstances. When the play opens, we find that Maura in deep mourning for her fifth son, Michael, who was drowned in the sea 9 days back. She is half crazy with weeping. She cannot sleep whole night, and she keeps going to the seashore to see whether Michael's body has been washed ashore. All her life, she has been watching the moods of the sea and crying and praying. She has suffered one disaster after another. The sea was the breadgiver of her family and also her worst enemy. Her sons, Stephen and Sean, were lost in the great wind, and finally their dead bodies were found. Her father-in-law, her husband, and her son, Seamus, were lost in a dark night. Her fourth son, Patch, was drowned when his boat was overturned. Michael was drowned 9 days ago. Now only Bartley is left, and she has a sign that he too would be drowned if he goes to sea that day. When Bartley passed that way to shale the horses, she could not give him the bread and the words of blessings stuck in her throat. She had a vision that he would also die, so she would be absolutely helpless. And finally, Bartley was also drowned into the sea. So all of them became a victim of evil fate, and her final son Bartley was also drawn into the sea. Moriarty showed great courage after looking Bartley's dead body. She does not wail and mourn. She does not faint. She recalls her past sorrows and finds consolation in the fact that now she will not have to cry or pray for anyone, and she will have long rest and undisturbed sleep during the long winter night. The whole play is a drama of her sorrows. We are tossed by her troubles because we feel that she is a living person. In her life, miseries had piled up one over the other, but these sorrows do not shatter her personality. She has a tremendous power of endurance. Misfortunes do not break down her spirit. She is calm in every difficulties. She is the victim of fate. And finally, she consoles herself, saying that no man at all can be living forever, and we must be satisfied, and we must lie in deep grave surely. So Moria is a truly great tragic figure. She does not suffer because of her any flaw in her own character. She is the victim of fate. So she is left utterly destitute. In the fight between man and the she is defeated. She finds consolation in the fact that nothing worse can happen to her. She will have peace and sound sleep. Her sufferings or misfortunes are great, but